Gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is DeLadysigner, and we are back with another speed build video of Meilin Zoo in sandbox mode. And this one, I actually wanted to upload this one yesterday, but this took me so long. And not really because of all the building, but it's just a huge habitat. And I have to thank one of the subscribers, Michael, for this, because he sent me a comment underneath the video and he was like, why don't you make something like this? And he sent a video of the Zurich Zoo, which we actually used during the beta 2 for the African elephants habitat, but then it was like the inside. So in this case, I honestly had no idea that the outside was so beautiful. I remember looking up some pictures of it, but I couldn't really see what was going on the outside. So I had no idea, but the outside is actually really cool. So I was like, oh my god, yes, I am going to start building this right away. Thank you so much, Michael, for suggesting this. Because I really wanted to have elephants now. Actually, this is the African area, but since we already had the African elephants in the beta, I really was like, no, I really want the Indian elephants right now, even though they're in the African area. I don't really mind that because I just really love how they look, and also because they like a little bit more sand and soil, if I remember correctly. So it gave me a little bit more freedom also with the rocks and rock terrain color to really make a nice habitat for them that can also look well, and they really enjoy it. So yeah, basically that is the reason why we took the Indian elephants instead of the African elephants. But oh my goodness, I'm so happy with how this is coming along. It's not really a recreation other than the fact that I really used a lot of the layout, especially the underwater viewing gallery. I am super excited for that to show you guys because it's just so awesome to see elephants swim. Obviously, they don't dive, but to see them swim, it really works well. Now, the guests in my zoo don't really care. They don't even go down there, but maybe when we have some more animals around this elephant's habitat, they will start using it. So I'm not really worried about that much. And obviously, I have been inspired by Silverat, but he has been inspired by Blijdorp of the Giraffe house. I'm not really sure how to call it. It was a shelter in Blijdorp, Rotterdam Zoo, and it's really awesome. And I had that in mind, obviously, to make something like that. Now, he already created something really awesome, so I just wanted to get some kind of shape of it, and I didn't do the walk-in area like you have in Rotterdam Zoo, but I basically inspired it a little bit of that. And also, Rudy Van Kemmel was working on something which he didn't upload yet, but both two really inspired me to create some kind of shelter for these guys, because we have the indoor area at the hippos, but I really didn't feel like I'm going inside again with these elephants in that same dome area. So I really felt like, no, I'm just gonna give them a shelter which is big enough for them to use, and we're gonna have the pygmy hippo, if I have enough space, inside where the hippo inside area is too. So yeah, I'm really excited to start building there too, but this took me so long. I actually cut out a lot of the footage because I was like, yeah, well, you guys have seen me placing down a lot of rocks and stuff, so I really try to make sure to give you guys still the idea of what I'm doing, but also like not every single rock, because I think this whole habitat took me around 8 hours or something. Like, I have been working on this for 2 days, and especially because it's just so big and I really wanted to do it right. And like that bridge you see right now, I actually removed that one because I was like, no, it doesn't feel right. But then I totally forgot, like I made like a very slope through the water so the elephants can just walk from one side to the other side, but I totally forgot that the staff just don't go through the water. So in the end, I cheated a little bit on the end so the staff can still walk around that water section on the end, but the elephants are not able to walk there. And I used a lot of the logs and stuff, because you see that often in elephant habitats, the logs will just make sure that the elephants can't pass through a section, and I just use that a little bit. I really tried to have it a little bit more realistic, but I then again ended up with a little bit of green sometimes in the habitat itself. So yeah, it's a little bit of a mixture, but I really try to make it a little bit more realistic with like higher end rocks with the trees and stuff on top of it, so the elephants would not be able to eat from it, if that makes sense. So yeah, that's something they really do a lot in real life zoos, so I try to approach that a little bit, so hopefully you guys like that. I'm really happy with how this area, this Indian elephants habitat turned out in the end, but it took me so long. And here you could see me just deleting a section because I was like, yeah, well, this habitat is already, I think it was 6,000 square meters. I kept saying cubic meters in a lot of my videos. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but it is actually square meters, and I was so confused. But so yeah, sorry in advance if I confuse anyone with that. But yeah, it's so huge, and obviously I was able to reduce it because I did put down a lot of rocks and stuff, but oh boy, it has been so much work, but so much fun. I'm so happy with how this turned out. And the viewing gallery underneath the water, I tried to attract some more people in there with a shop, with the Hats Fantastic shop. But no one still have ever used that whole section. So yeah, I'm really curious if that will change if we add some more different animals surrounding this. I was actually quite surprised with the Indian elephant that it doesn't get enrichment from any other species. So I wasn't able to say like, okay, it's so big, I can easily add another animal in here. Like obviously I can try to see what animal would fit, but I was just surprised. Like the African elephant has so many different species you can combine it with. And for the Indian elephant, there's just nothing. So yeah, I'm like, if you guys have any suggestions of what kind of animal we could possibly add. But in the end, I'm also like, we can just maybe keep it like this because it's just really nice and beautiful. And you can have, I think it was around 30 elephants in one habitat. So that will be really cool if we can just have a lot of it. But talking about that, as I said in the previous episode, I have a lot of struggles with the breeding, and I don't know if that is because this is my early access park or maybe because of the last update. Well, the Indian peafowl breeds like nuts. It's seriously, they're like rabbits, so that's not the issue. But the hippos, even though they have like 99% chance of offspring, they don't get any babies. The timber wolves have 100% chance of offspring and they don't have any babies. And now playing around with the Indian elephant, they also have a high chance to get some offspring, but they're just, nothing happens. And it's a little bit disappointing, and I am really afraid that it's because this is a early access park, so for some reason there might be something in there that is bogged and it will just not really work properly like when you would start a new sandbox park right now. So yeah, I'm a little bit afraid of that, but I did report these bugs and hopefully Frontier is able to fix this, but I am I don't have that much hope for it, unfortunately. But yeah, who knows, we will see some more babies in this zoo. Like as I said, the Indian peafowl and the Japanese macaque and all the other animals, Komodo dragon, saltwater crocodile, they all have babies. So it's not in my settings. I did see a few people saying like, oh yeah, you have to change your settings because maybe that's why they can't get any offspring. But that's not the case. My settings are all good and other animals are perfectly fine to get some offspring. So yeah, I really have no idea what that exactly is, but I really, really keep my fingers crossed that that will change in a later stage, because I just want to see some really cute baby Indian elephants. That will be so amazing. So yeah, we're going to have an underwater viewing gallery, and the entrance for it will be inside of that dome. At first, I thought maybe I could have it like in a completely different area, but I was like, no, just stay close to it. But I didn't have space next to this path section you see to squeeze it in there. I did try it, but it didn't work. There's just not enough space for it. And the other path will be interrupting, so it's just not possible to put anything down there. So I went inside the dome, right among the corner, and then you will have a cave going down, and then the people can see the elephants swim, and I will definitely put in some cinematic shots in the end of this video to see, to show you guys how that looks, because it's just absolutely awesome to see that. So yeah, I really hope you guys enjoy this video. Make sure to subscribe, of course, if you already haven't, and leave a like at the video if you guys enjoy. And in the next video, we will definitely build the pygmy hippo habitat, because they're super cute, and I really want to finish off this area with the dome. So yeah, I'm super excited for that. Stay tuned. Let me know in the comment section how you guys feel of this new area. And I really hope to see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.